नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श छू। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी।
हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी सम मोर क्वेश्चंस ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 7.2। दिस इज द एक्सरसाइज ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 10 चैप्टर नंबर 7 कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री। सो बिफोर वी स्टडी दिस एग्जांपल्स, लेट अस रिमेंबर दैट before this we have studied the section formula, and the section formula is what, that if the three points are on the same line, then the point which is in between the two points is divide the line segment in some ratio, in some proportion. So today we will have to discuss about the special case of the mid formula. And what is that special case? Now think, if what will happen, the point which is in between the two point is the midpoint of the line segment, then this portion, first portion and the second portion will have the equal length, because the point is the midpoint. So both the lengths will be the equal. If this portion is 5 cm, then second one is also the 5 cm. Then what will happen, the ratio M1, M2, M1 and M2, both the lengths are equal. So when we divide it, what we get? 1. That means 1:1. So whenever there is a midpoint of any line segment, it will divide it into the two equal parts, and the ratio M1:M1 will be 1:1. See, one of the example, that is a diagonal of the circle. This is the circle with center O, and AB is the diagonal. So yes, from O to B is a radius, O to A radius, both are the equal. So this line segment AB, the diagonal AB, is divided by the center O into two equal parts. So here we can say that yes, M1 and M2 are 1:1. So M1:M2 we can write down as 1:1. So what is the formula we can get here for the midpoint? Right? See, this is the formula we are using, that M2 into x1 plus m1 into x2 upon m1 plus m2. So now in place of m1 and m2 we have to put 1. So this is m2 x1 plus m1 x2 upon m1 plus m2, that means 1 plus 1. For the same we have to write down for the y coordinate, m2 y1 plus m1 y2 upon m1 plus m2. Again in place of m1 and m2 we have to put 1 and 1. So here 1 into x1 is x1, 1 into x2 is x2, and 1 plus 1 is equals to 2. So here we get the x coordinate is equals to x1 plus x2 upon 2. In the same way, here we get y1 plus y2 upon 2. So when there is a point which divides the line segment into two equal parts, that means the point is the midpoint, then we can find out the coordinate of that midpoint directly by dividing, by adding the x coordinate of the first point, second point, divide by 2. y1 plus y2, the coordinate, y coordinate of first point, y coordinate of the second point, divide by 2. So this is what the special case of the section formula. Okay, let us see, let us study the examples related to this special case. So here the question number 6 is what? In the question number 6 we have given that if 1, 2, 4y, x, 6, 3, 5 are the vertices of a parallelogram taken in order, find x and y. So here we have said that 4 coordinates we have given, and all the coordinates are of a special quadrilateral, that is a parallelogram, and all the points are in the order. So if we take A as 1, 2, B is 4y, C is x, 6 and D is 3, 5. Now how can we find out this y and x? See, here we can use this section, we can use the distance formula. So this distance and this distance will be the equal, but here we get the two variables. If we apply distance formula here and here, then also we get the two variables. Here we get x, here we get y. So by this we cannot solve it. So how we can solve it? Here we have to use the section formula, and that is of the special case of the section formula. See, here we can say that if we draw the diagonals AC and BD, and this is what O. O is the intersecting point of both the diagonals. So we can say that O is the midpoint of diagonals AC and BD, because remember the diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. Bisect means two equal portion. OA and OC are equal, OD and OB are equal. That what mean O is the midpoint of AC as well as BD. Right? So what is this O? Is the midpoint. We can use this formula to find out the coordinate of point O. Actually, we do not want to find out the coordinate of point O. But using this formula, whatever is the unknown value, that we can find out. See how we can use this. So, midpoint formula, here we can write down as x1 plus x2 upon 2, y1 plus y2 upon 2. So, midpoint of AC is equals to midpoint of BD, because that is the same point. O is the midpoint of AC as well as BD. So, when we apply this midpoint formula for this diagonal AC, then what we can write down? x1 plus x2 upon 2. For this diagonal, x1, x2 is x1, y1 is 1, 2, x2, y2 is x6. So, x1 plus x2, that is 1 plus x upon 2, and y coordinate is 2 plus 6 upon 2. That is equals to midpoint of BD. Now, apply this midpoint formula for this line segment BD. O is the midpoint. Here, this we can say x1, y1. This will be x2, y2. So, x1 plus x2, that is 4 upon 2. And here, y1 plus y2, that is 5 plus y upon 2. Now, simplify this. Okay, here we get. Okay, we can directly compare it. The x coordinate, we can compare with this x coordinate. Y coordinate, we can compare with this y coordinate. So, see, when we compare this x with x coordinate, we get the value of x. When we compare the y coordinate with this y coordinate, we get the value of y. So, compare this x coordinate. So, here we get 1 plus x upon 2 is equals to 4 plus 3 is 7. 7 upon 2. Now, 2 is both the side on the denominator. We can cancel out it. So, here we get 1 plus x is equals to 7. Now, by taking this 1 to the right hand side, it will be subtracted from the 7 and we get the value of x is equals to 6. In the same way, by comparing the y coordinate, here we get 6 plus 2 is 8. 8 upon 2 is equals to 5 plus y upon 2. Again, we can cut here 2 and 2. So, here we get 8 is equals to 5 plus y. Now, take this 5 to the right hand side. 8 minus 5 is equals to y, and therefore the value of y we get is equals to 3. So in this way, whatever the unknown values of x and y, we can find out using the special case of section formula. Right? So this is what the special case of midpoint, special case of section formula, that is we can also say at the midpoint formula. And how we can use that. Let us study one more example, one more question, that is question number 7. Find the coordinates of a point A where AB is the diameter of a circle whose center is 2 minus 3 and B is 1, 4. So here we have to find out the coordinate of point A. The center, coordinate of the center that we have given, and let's suppose that is O, 2 minus 3. And the coordinate of point B, that is also we have given, 1, 4. So, let's suppose the coordinate of point A is xy. By using the special case of section formula or midpoint formula, now we can write down that the coordinate of this point, 2, 3, 2 minus 3, we can write down as x1 plus x2, that is x plus 1, upon 2, y plus 4 upon 2, right? This is the point which divides the line segment AB into the two equal parts, and these are the points we can find out, we can get from the spatial case. Now compare x coordinate with x, y coordinate with y coordinate. So 2 is equals to x plus 1 upon 2. By taking this 2 here, we get 4 is equals to x plus 1, and therefore the value of x we get is equals to 4 minus 1, that is 3. In the same way, we can compare the y coordinate. Minus 3 is equals to y plus 4 upon 2. So we get minus 6 is equals to y plus 4. And therefore, the y we get here is minus 6 minus 4, that is minus 10. So the point we want to find out A, that we have suppose x, y, and its value we get here is 3 minus 10. Okay, so this is how we can use the midpoint formula for different types of problems. Okay, so this is all about this lecture. Thank you.
Thank you for joining us.